Everything is revolved around music, about violence, about the bows I play, about which concertos to do the next season, preparing new pieces, being in the studio thinking about music the whole time, what could be a great new album, which title would work on the violin. Basically my mind, and this is really true, it's like a 24-hour soundtrack of music going on. There is no stopping. I think the biggest goal in music is to be excited by it. In the moment I do something, I do it wholeheartedly. And of course, during the year, I switch programs. I play 2 months classical, then I play a few crossover shows, then I go again do some classical, then I have 2 months crossover touring. I'm always there with my full heart, with my attention, with my brain, with my soul. And otherwise, this would not work. I always find, and I think that is a little bit the key of getting attention, is passion. Every day as a musician, you need to be your best. At least that's my theory. Because yesterday does not count. It's only what counts, what you do today. You're not being judged, or I don't judge myself on a success from yesterday. The only thing which counts is the moment and what you do with it. I want people to enjoy music, and wherever that leads is their own choice. I want people to enjoy music like I enjoy music, and that is without limits, without genres. For me, if I go on stage, I know literally every part in the orchestration. And only then you can have a conversation, a musical one. And only then you feel secure. And then you don't have to memorize. It's like walking across the street. You don't need to memorize how to walk across the street. You do it. And you don't think about what's coming next. It's just there. How can I not be influenced by pop, rock, R&B, electronic music? It's what is all around. I would be a weirdo if this would not influence me. Music has not changed. Everybody's like, oh, crossover classical. A human being has created something from their emotions, created something with the possibilities of instruments from that time. But it's still our emotions. I would not do this profession, this job, and it is a very tough job at times, if I would not enjoy also traveling. I love also getting home, but after a while I miss making music.
There's a certain magic when he plays that goes over the stage and into the audience. Whether he does it on purpose or not, I don't think so. I think it's just a part of David. He loved to play. He climbed every tree in our garden and fell out of every tree. He liked sports. He liked to be with his brother and sister. But he was very active child. The only time, the only time he was really quiet was when he had the violin in his hand and played. Then he would stand and be quiet. A lot of things to do. He was always busy, the same as he is now. He was always new thoughts, and I should do this, and let's do that. And a busy child. Then he was David as 5, 6, 7 year old. He was himself. But when he played, you can discipline every child as far as possible, but without the passion to play, there's no chance. When he was little, he used to say, I want to be in the circus. I always wanted to be a clown. When he was tiny, he said, I'm going to go to the circus. Which he did in some sort of way. He is in the circus, yeah.